It was nothing less than chaos. Medics racing to rescue more than a dozen elderly residents after they were abandoned by the majority of the caregivers at Valley Springs Manor Home.
How could somebody do that? We're talking human beings here. How do you just abandon them? It's a bad situation.
A bad situation is exactly what the state of California says was happening here for years, according to this complaint from the Department of Social Services, which was in the process of shutting the place down. Last Thursday, the state suspended Valley Springs' license, citing a long list of violations, including insufficient employee training, failure to provide necessary medications to patients, not properly treating or reporting patient injuries, and poor maintenance and cleanliness. Once the government stepped in, the owners were not allowed near the facility. End of story, right? Wrong. Some patients were still there.
By the close of business on Friday, anyone with any authority was gone, nowhere to be found. The residents were left in the hands of two caregivers and a cook who says they didn't have the proper training to do all that they were doing for the residents, but they felt compelled to stay.
This man, Maurice Rowland, a cook at the home for 3 months, says he and the other untrained workers took over, trying to do anything they could to look after the residents who needed round-the-clock care.
Did you feel overwhelmed with what you had to do for these residents?
I was already overwhelmed on day two.
Overwhelmed, he says, because the patients needed help with everything, from using the bathroom to preparing their meals and even taking medication, which no one was authorized to provide.
He definitely wasn't the people that supposed to be giving them their meds.
Why did you decide to stay?
Because I could. I mean, in my eyes, I had to stay because I couldn't leave the residents there by themselves. Ain't no telling what could have happened if I would have left.
Rowland says so many residents needed urgent care that he kept calling 911 for different patients.
We just get up there and find, you know, the 14 people with nobody really there to care for them. So paramedics plus ambulance company and you know, got them all transported to the hospitals.
What's more, the families of the people abandoned at the home didn't even know it had been shut down. Jean Pong paid the facility $3,000 a month to care for her sister, but she arrived to find she wasn't cared for at all.
I think they should be held accountable. I mean, you just can't vacate and leave your residence without proper care. I mean, this is what you pay for.
There were no answers at the facility when we came looking for the owner, Hilda Manuel. We also looked for her at her home. Nobody answered. So why did the Department of Social Services, which wanted to close the facility, just leave without making sure the patients would be taken care of?
Staff at the facility had indicated that they could provide care of the residents through the weekend. That should not have occurred.
They say there's no doubt they dropped the ball.
The owners failed these residents. I think there's no one who's going to doubt that part. Do you believe then that the state also failed these residents?
Again, like I said, it's that we had procedures that should have been followed and they weren't, and we're going to figure out why that happened and what we can do to ensure that that doesn't happen again.
So that would be a yes to your question. So you weren't able to find the owner, but just talked to their attorney. What did they say about the residents who were left behind?
Well, Anderson, the attorney says, when I spoke to him this afternoon, that authorities here jumped the gun by removing all of the residents from the house. They were working to settle some of those violation issues with the government. And they're also saying that there is no way that the owner of this property was trying to abandon these residents. She just wanted to transfer them out in an orderly fashion.